before I so rudely interrupted myself about the Sun Princess Ring, and the Darkwraith, you know, I wonder if the... Oh, there are my souls. So I guess we're getting close. Oh yeah, we are. There you are. Jackass. Why is this guy so good? Why is this enemy so good? Now I'm just pissing through embers. Alright, we're just gonna run this. You know what? We've already explored that wall, and we have found it lacking. So anyway, now we'll just get back to the Sun Princess Ring. And, you know, I wonder if it works off of. Actually works off of your health, so does it regenerate health by a static amount, or is there a second health that it will regenerate? You know, come on, rush, please. Oh God, I love it. I love it. I don't have the range. You know, 1 out of 5, that's pretty good, right? Hey, I'm getting some cool Dark Knight shit out of it, so why not? We'll just keep farming you, buddy. Thanks for the cracked red eye orbs and the Dark Knight shit. But I do wonder if it's... if it's a static amount, so it's just like, you know, some Princess Ring just gives you 5 HP per second. Or if it's based on your current HP, so, or based on your maximum HP, so it's like, you know, 1% of your maximum HP per second. So the more HP you have, in a sense, the better it does for you. Yeah. Of course. Of course. And a Titanite Shard. I was at least hoping for an Ember. For Pete's sake. That would have been nice. Hang on. And boop. So I could have at least gotten one of my embers back. I mean, because I have so few right now, you know, sitting at 19. As it is. You know, the ember economy is really tough right now. Oh. Thankfully, you're the ones that don't jump on my face and then eat it. So, I'm okay with just kind of letting you get at me or get close. You're, by all considerations, you're not nearly as dangerous as your upright bipedal brethren. Okay, so we cannot chop that down. At least it does not appear that we can. Nope. Alright. So there must have been an item up there that we got already, and we just don't need to go back. Okay, come get me? Nope. Alright. Fine, you just stay there then. That's cool. I don't mind. Whatever, you do you, okay? You do you. And that's just, you know, and that's beautiful. Whatever that is that you do. Uh, Okay, so there's a facade over there. This is where I murdered. I got murdered twice. Right? I'm still in the right area, Anna. Am I? Oh, jeez. Oh no, I've lost track. I stopped paying close attention to where I was. Oh shit. And now I'm somewhere. Of course I am. Shit. Okay, you're both weaponized. So, you're both not dangerous. Because you're not that crazy one that will leap on my face. Nope. I've gotta beware the ones that do not carry weapons and stand upright. Those are the ones I have to watch out for. These guys aren't anything. It's nothing that I can't handle. Aha! Okay, so this is where I was, and I just did a loop-de-loop around this thing. That's where I was. That was the direction I was going. Okay, and I kind of doubled back around this thing. Okay. Alright. Hey, these areas are the worst when you're looking for secrets. Okay, these ones are awful. Because it's just a wide open space, and there's really, you know, there's essentially no set path. So you could just get lost. I mean, very easily just get lost out here. And I'm sure we're probably still gonna do that. Let's not kid ourselves, we're probably still gonna do that. But at least we'll get lost together. Together, friendship, all that happy stuff. Can't walk into there. I'm sure I tried before. I'm sure I've tried long, long ago. So, let's see. Kind of losing track of my stories here. Well, I had the, you know, I did the acting class thing, and then, what happened next? Well, that was the most recent thing, anyways. Last weekend, we were out freaking travel. And I should say air travel. That's really it. The issue is air travel. I don't know how many of you have, you know, done air travel recently. Oh, this is... Wow, we've just doubled back that way. So that was the entrance. Fantastic. Okay. Alright. Well, we know where we are now. There was the entrance. You know what? Let's go right. But I don't know how many of you have flown by plane or traveled. How else did you fly lately? I took a jetpack. That's pretty cool. traveled by airplane. And, let me tell you, it doesn't get any more fun. Like, the more you do it, could this be? And they still just stuff you as many people as they can into a single aircraft, and there's pretty much always, certainly now that it's summer, oh, good lord, everybody, you know, so many people are traveling now, and they just all stuff you in like sardines, and every time there's always a list for standby, and so they're always taking, volunteers. Would you like to not fly today? Would you like to turn home so that, oh my god, that curse built up. Would you like to go back home today and get back through, you know, have to come back through security again? Another time? Because obviously, when you're flying by plane, you haven't made plans, okay? Obviously. That's obviously not what you've done. You know, if you're flying by an airplane, obviously you have all the flexibility in the world. You're clearly just doing this for the fun of it. So then they always ask, oh, would you like to give up your seat? No. I planned this trip for a reason. There are things I'm doing once I get to my destination. I'm not just riding the friendly skies for shits and giggles. This wasn't like I said, oh, let me just hop on a plane today. You know, let me just, oh, shit. That discreet buildup. God, that hurts. It's just annoying. You're like, oh, I have all this, you know, curse resist. And then all of a sudden, tick, tick, tick. And you're like, oh my god, it was only 4 hits worth of curse resist. Oh, Jesus. And now I'm cursed and dead. You know, and I mean, I get it. I get that, you know, no matter what, they're losing money all the time. Airlines are just not a viable business strategy at all. Somehow, I mean, thanks to, you know, them still using fossil fuel jets and what forth, that doesn't help. but so I understand that they're like, we've got to sell all the tickets we can. Can this plane only carry 100 people? Yep. Well, let's sell 200 tickets and we'll send, you know, we'll just put all those 100 other people on another plane. It's fine. They'll be fine with it. It's okay. Don't worry about it. It's okay. They're just numbers. They're not real people. But I don't understand how it's actually a better business model for them to continually overbook flights and then give people like 200, 300, maybe even more dollars back to say, oh, well, thank you for taking a different flight. Thank you for completely rearranging your schedule and for having all of this free time to do this. Thank you for doing that. You know, like, how does that... Yeah, you are a scary one. You need to die fast. We've been through here. Okay. You know, I guess, yeah, it doesn't make any sense how that's somehow better than just simply saying, okay, flight's full, you don't get to fly anymore. We're not selling seats, you know, you can't buy tickets for this flight. But then again, they're like, well, we can't leave our aircraft possibly, you know, possibly only 98% full. Every aircraft has to be 100% full. Because otherwise, then we're wasting fuel, which is expensive. Okay then, but, you know, isn't that a little crazy that you're, like, overbooking? Still, it seems, if you got an airplane that's 98% full versus an airplane that's 100% full, how much fuel are you wasting? Because you're still bringing that many people? You know, you're still eventually going to bring that other 2%. They're just going to be on a different flight. So, you know, why is them being on a different subsequent flight somehow worse for you? And I guess they look at, well, those other people could now be on, you know, this first flight. So flight number one could be 100% full, and then flight number two can be 100% full, rather than flight one being 98% full, then flight two being, you know, 98% full, so on, so forth. Just, you know, the pattern continues forever, I guess, is their thing. Sorry, I decided to become a frog for a few moments. I don't know what happened. We probably need to explore that side too. I know that there's a bonfire in here, which means that maybe we'll take this bonfire the next time we... Oh yeah, so we've been... Oh, so we've already been that way. That's cool to know. I like knowing that. Ow! Ow! Yep. We're about to be pincered here. They're going for a pincer maneuver. Nope, I guess I gave up on that idea. They said, screw it, that's dumb. Pincer maneuvers are stupid. So yeah, I guess they must just believe it's like some sort of, you know, cascade pattern. Oh, now the next plane is, subsequent planes are 2% less full again, so now eventually we're flying planes that are only 80% full. Which honestly makes no sense. Because everybody, you know, needs flights, so why would they, you know, people are still gonna buy tickets for flights. Just what? Can you tell I'm not a fan of just being squeezed into a seat that's too small in between, or just at least next to at least one, if not two, other people that you just don't care about. Oh shit, did I just do that? Oh, thank god there was a way to get out. Ooh, that would have been frustrating, to say the least. You know, maybe it's just my personality that I'm not an air travel person. And I'm just, oh, I see. Yeah, probably. Probably could be a ranged battle. I just don't. Oh, hey. So we're back. Okay, cool. So we've gone past those three guys. We came up to this guy. He murdered us once. He murdered us twice. He murdered us three times, the lady. Now we're here. Okay. So sadly, I think we actually have explored this area. Damn, it's kind of sad. Didn't find a secret, so that's a little upsetting. I am processing. My brain hurts for it. Oh, right. That is a scary motherfucking ghost. That is a very scary ghost. See, more proof, though, that we haven't found everything yet, because people have found the symbol of avarice, and we have not yet. Oh, right, there's the crab. Oh, yep, we still got areas to explore, then. Still gotta go this way, because we have not, clearly. Oh. So yeah, maybe it's just me as a person that's just not into this sort of thing. I mean, maybe, you know, I know that there are some people who are just like, oh, they're positive, they're outgoing, so they're just like, yeah, whatever, I'll sit next to whoever, I'll talk to whoever, it's cool, yay! We're all crammed in here, none of us want to be, hooray. Apparently I was going to backstab. Somehow. But it isn't me, and oh god, it's just, wait, what the, holy crap, I went right past the, wow, that crab is really in like a cove, isn't it? So what the hell was I seeing this, oh, that was still the, wow, that is, oh shit. Shit. I need to be able to get around Mr. Krabby Patty here. Mr. Krabs. Oh. Mr. Krabs, please. There we go. Yeah, it doesn't get... plane travels, this doesn't get any easier each time. I mean, you know, thank God Madam Noob and I are usually able to get seats together. That makes it way nicer, at least. But we're still... I mean, we're both still crammed in there. And it's just... just so annoying. Because I can't get enough space. And I mean, I'm not, like, I'm not a big guy, you know? I'm actually kind of... When I think about it, I'd be what many sources would say is average. Whatever that means these days. But, you know, I'm not super tall. I'm not super wide. God, those seats are just awful. You know, and then I always love it because you always walk by the first class people. You know, they're always the first ones on. Why do you want to be first? I would actually, if I was flying first class, I'd show up last. I'd be like, whatever. I'm gonna walk on last because, hey, I'm gonna be in this seat for the next, you know, 4, 5, 10,000 hours. I don't really need to be sitting down 10 minutes earlier than everyone else. Or, I mean, who are we kidding? It takes like a half hour to board a plane. Because you've always got those, oh, yep, here it comes. Here comes the rant about fucking air travel. Because then you've got those people who just, like, they absolutely have to have all of their shit on the airplane. And mind you, it's, you know, they say, okay, bring on one carry-on item and a personal item. Fine, makes sense. You know, that's great. Good stuff. Yeah, except then you've got those giant just jerks that pack a solid bag, or a solid case, actually. They pack those, you know, plastic or metal cases that have no give to them. Yeah, and we're moving on. And they pack them right in, you know, and they just, some of them don't make it, some of them just barely do in the overhead compartment, and then they've also got their, like, stupidly full laptop bag that's essentially, like, the size of my carry-on. Like, that's what they're bringing. They're like, this is my carry-on, this is my personal item. You do realize you're supposed to share the overhead compartment with other people, right? Like, there's supposed to be, like, three bags in there, maybe? 3 to 4, you know? One for each person in the row. You know, right? Oh, shit. Oh, do it? Okay, never mind. Not nearly as scary. More of you? Whatever. And they... Oh, so they put it in there and it, like, fills up the frickin', you know, overhead. And... One, it's incredible the airline just lets it go, but you know what? They probably had that battle so many freaking times that they just say, fine, fuck it, whatever, we're not dealing with you. And then they do that, and then, you know, that's... You know it's a problem when the airline essentially says to you, okay, so if you're in boarding group 4 or 5, which are kind of like the... You know, if you haven't been on a plane in a while, those are generally like the last two boarding groups. Like, that's pretty much it. Like, if you're in one of those, you're last to get on the plane, or to get called to get on the plane. And if you're in one of those, the airline now actually tells you, like, oh, hey, heads up, you probably want to check your carry-on, because this is a full flight, and there just won't be the space. Why won't there be the space? Because of douchebags like that, who keep putting giant bags that are not carry-on into the overhead compartments. there. Oh, this way. It's infuriating. I can't stand it. You know, and then you've always got those people. I did like this. I liked that on the way back, you know, I've always wondered about, you know, whether or not people can just wander in, because they're like, okay, we're boarding group two, and there's like 3,000 people going in line. Now, this is going to be a problem, because that's two of them. Let's see if I can just peel one off. Oh, I just ruined that. Uh-oh. Ow. Ow, ow. You stop that. There we go. Alright, now it's better. Oh! Okay. But I always wondered if those, you know, because then you scan the barcode of your boarding pass, and then it's like, okay, get in. Get on the plane. And I've always wondered if those were, if there was actually any actual checking, or if it was just simply like, oh, they're supposed to be on the plane, okay, get on the plane. So if you were boarding group 5, you could just walk in with boarding group 2. And when we were heading back, they had the ticket taker, they had the person working behind the desk taking boarding passes and swiping them, or at least kind of manually checking them. And then they had an automated one, and these two, it was beautiful, because these two jackasses went to the automated one, and the automated one just went, eh-eh. It was going red, and they're like, what's going on? And the person working at the desk looked and said, oh, well, we're only boarding these groups right now. You're not there yet. We're not there yet. And they're like, oh, okay. All right.
Stupid. Whatever. Everything's dumb.
And they, and I said, holy shit, it actually works. Yay. With these guys, I guess, they were like a group after us, and they were like one group back from what was still boarding. And I just thought, holy shit, this thing is, they're real. They do actually check, and they're like, okay, no, only these groups are allowed for now. And it's like, oh, yay. So you can't game the system. Okay, so there are just this many people. That's the thing, is 100 plus people just standing in line looks like a shit ton of people when you walk through it and you're looking at it. And then, you know, when you're in those lines, they're not really lines, you could call them queues, but they're just a freaking mess. And I've always got those people who are like, which line is this? Because they're never a line, and And even we've had to do that, because everybody's just in this mass, and you're like, okay, so who's standing in line for this group? Who's standing in line for this group? And we're just like, like, oh my god, please stop being so dumb, please stop sucking. Alright, so we've reached the Abyss Watchers. And there was stuff to do down here. I think this is where this continues. I mean, that area was pretty... Thankfully, that area is pretty cut and dry. Thank God. I like those. I like areas like that, where we can just kind of run through them. Now we come down here to the Catacombs of Karthus. Such a fun fucking place. Can't wait to go through here. Also, I'm impressed. We didn't get stuck on simply the swamp. So that's good. Because I really thought that was where we were just going to be stuck. You know, maybe I'm cutting corners. You know, that's certainly possible. Did we ever do this? I don't know. Let's try this shit. What, you know, what's down here? Clearly we can drop down here. And I'm thinking that the first time we ever came down here, we never checked this place out because, you know. Oh, hello. Oh, I think I do remember you being a dickbag, though, when I was last here. because you were shooting me, and I was like, what the shit, how do I deal with you? But apparently that's how you come this way, and you work your way down.